Hello everybody, my name is Erica and welcome to my channel, Ginger Books. So my goal this year with this channel is to do some more fun stuff, so I at least have 1 to 2 weeks kind of put aside so that we can have fun book tag entertainment. So I have not popular enough to be tagged in any of this, so I'm just doing them for fun. So one of the things is that I've always wanted to do a bookshelf tour since last year when I started getting more books, except this monstrosity of a shelf is not ready. However, since I've gotten a new shelf out in my dining room and I have my other shelf now is full of my favorite books that I wanted to at least display right away so that they're not just accumulating dust and everything over there. We're gonna do a bookshelf tour, I guess, is what my rambling is going towards. I'm gonna show you 2 shelves. I'm not gonna show you every book. I'll probably just highlight like my favorite series and maybe some of like the special editions that I have. But, or I should say I have 3 shelves and I'm missing a book up there. But you'll get it. So let's get into it. All right, so getting started. Sorry, had to take a pause to set up a light of some sort, so I have my ring light. So this is what the shelf looks like. It is only pretty much 4 shelves with a top. So starting with the top, I love Halloween, so some of my Halloween decorations are still up. Absolutely love them. So a lot of the decoration is like candles and Funko Pops, and one of them fell down. But up here, I have like my exclusive like first edition of Mark, and then the UK edition of Destined, along with a couple of knickknacks from the Owl Crate boxes and my Wisdom Oracle cards. Along with, I love Haunted Mansion, Disney's Haunted Mansion, so I have a couple of Funko Pops from them. Also with Raja, because he's my favorite Aladdin sidekick, along with the genie. And then I have Zero from A Nightmare Before Christmas. Also right here, that I really want to get into since I read excerpts from Leigh Bardugo. I really want to get into her writing. She fascinates me. So I have the complete trilogy of the Grishaverse. And then I have Six of Crows, Crooked Kingdom, and King of Scars that I need to get into this year, hopefully. So the second shelf, this bookshelf is kind of themed around dark paranormal, paranormal romance, vampire, and mythical creatures. What it's kind of themed about, it might change. Who knows? But I have I think two of the novellas of the House of Night series, which was my all-time favorite series in high school. The fun story behind this series is that my mom recommended it to me since I love Twilight, but I was like, no, nothing can replace Twilight. I literally read the first 2 books and became absolutely hooked. So I have Legacy, the House of Night, graphic novel, which is of the Otherworld series. Or no, this one, I believe, is the first graphic novel. My bad. So this is over part marked. So I have the whole complete set, and it's a mix of paperback into hardback. I do kind of want to get the other hardbacks because I just prefer hardbacks. And I do not have the sleeves to it because they used to be like posters when you took them out. And I had them hung up for years on my wall, and when I went to take them down multiple different times rearranging my room, they broke. So yeah. And then I have the Otherworld series right here. This was damaged because I got this for Christmas. Yeah, we're not going to talk about that. Kristen Cass, which is PC Cass's daughter, that co-writes with her for the, and I have Amber Smoke, which is kind of like a Greek mythology type story, and I have this one, and then I have Scarlet Rain as an ebook, and she really needs to release more on it. I understand she had a baby not a few years ago, but still she needs to get back on it because I really love that series. Then of course I have my Twilight series, which I have hardbacks and everything, and now I also have the paperbacks and everything. And then I have my very first Twilight book I ever owned was a mass paperback copy for the movie. And you can obviously see how many times I've read that book. Now, coming down to the second one is a lot of, again, a mix of paranormal, supernatural, mystery thrillers, and also retelling. So I have Roseblood, which is like a continuation type retelling of Phantom of the Opera. Wow, I can't believe I forgot that. And then Cruel Beauty is a retelling by Splinter series. It's by the same author. It's a retelling of Beauty and the Beast. And then Crimson Bound is supposed to be a retelling of Little Red Riding Hood. I only read like maybe a chapter into it and then got bored and stopped reading it. I may pick it up again. If not, if I don't, then I might unhaul it. So, and then over here, kind of fitting the theme, even though these should be with my literature self and like my history slash literature. But Frankenstein and Dracula are on here because they're my all-time favorite classic literature. Mary Shelley was just a genius along with Bram Stoker. And then, of course, highlighting. Kind of the books I like to highlight that were my favorites. If they don't have like multiple, like the PC and Kristen Cast series. Is my Carrie Maniscalco Stalking Jack the Ripper series. Love, love, love. If you love history, crime, and romance. Definitely check this series out. Loved it last year. It was my all-time favorite series of last year. And it is definitely number two of my all-time favorite series. Now over here, a mix of things that just don't have a complete series yet. Or I haven't read and just didn't know where really well to fit them and put them. So I have The Shadow Falls, The Beginning, which is the two books from, what is it called? The Shadow Falls series. And then Reborn, which is part of that. It's the After Dark. Then I have The Hazelwood, which I believe I bought off of Book Outlet because it seemed interesting. The Bone Witch. This trilogy was my absolute favorite by Kelly Armstrong. The Summoning series. Loved it. I need to get the third book. Believe I have the first and third book. I'm not 100% sure. Then Wicked Saints, because I've heard nothing but good things about that. Holly Black's The Cruel Prince, because I'm trying to get into pretty much like fairy fantasy romance type books, and so I definitely wanted to get that one. And then There Will Come a Darkness. Moving on down, this has a little bit more of adult, and a couple of, obviously my Death Note fits into kind of this category where everything is pretty much like psychological thriller, horror on this shelf, whether it be adult, except for over here. It just ignore that part because I just needed to fill the shelf. So I have Ruth Wire, I have Heather Graham, I have Ninth House, which I definitely want to get to this year. Two editions of 10th Girl. I bought one and then ended up getting one in a subscription box. So I have two editions of that. I have Anthony Horowitz, Stephen King, which I definitely want to get into this year. And then I have Thunderhead here, but Scythe is on my TBR cart right over here. Hopefully getting to that series this year too. And then I have like my kind of like ghost paranormal type books with What the Dead Want, The Haunting of the Sunshine Girl, Miss Peregrine's Home for Peculiar Children, Asylum, and Two Can Keep a Secret. Now the last thing on this shelf is anybody who knows me knows I love researching about the paranormal. So everything down here, well, besides these books, which are more paranormal stories, besides the Cedar Falls one here, and then this astrology and psychologically sign or whatever, what is it called? Through a psychic's eye, sorry. So that's this Sylvia Brown book. But over here is all of my paranormal books. So I have a big encyclopedia on ghosts, which like goes over ghost hunting, why ghosts even, you know, the theories of why they exist and everything. Then I have Ghostly Encounters, which is like true stories from people all across America. Haunted inns and hotels. I have an Iowa Road Guide to Haunted Places. I actually have three of them. Haunted New Orleans, because, you know, down there it's probably the most haunted places in America. Haunted Love, America's Most Haunted Ghosts. Haunted Asylums, the World's Most Haunted Places. The two Iowa books, as I pointed out. New Orleans Ghosts, Voodoo, and Vampires. And then the two Zach Bagan books that he released. Weird Hauntings, and then, of course, what I pointed out. So, that is this shelf, and we'll move on to the next one. Okay, so this room has a little bit better lighting in it. And this is this shelf, which is kind of like more of a cabinet-type shelf. So, again, it's just like a small, standard shelf. So, sitting up on top of here is like my Humboldt and Iowa history books. A couple of these are like 70s editions of them. So I have the Hawkeye Tales, I have the Sartoria Legacy, which is more over in Blackhawk County. We have our first quarter of the second century, which is continuation off of our 100-year one that was done for our centennial. And then some more. Some of these are actually textbooks that I bought. I actually had to read these for school. And then the signs and symbols. And I do apologize if you hear my boyfriend talking, because this is like near his office, so you might hear some gameplay action in there right now. He's gaming with friends. So, Solidarian Survival, The Sacred Cause of the Union, A Small Prairie Town, Pioneer, Iowa. Then this is the 100-year history, Humboldt County. You get it. So, down here, so the way this bookshelf is organized is into time periods, since this is more of my history shelf, which has literature. It can be considered history because you can learn a thing or two behind why they're writing, like the atmosphere, why they're writing like that and all that stuff, yada, yada, yada. So over here is my ancient civilization type shelf. So this would cover Egypt, like this book says, and this is Bugs Bunny because he's my favorite character. And then of course I have Bird Person because we love Rick and Morty in this household. Cleopatra, ancient Egypt, most of my ancient Egypt's right here, and civilizations. Then I have over here Greece, Rome, religions, which kind of covers the Asian sector, and Norse mythology part of this. Then I have over here pretty much like the classic literatures that kind of followed the time periods going from Gilgamesh over to pretty much the fall of the Roman Empire. And then I have the old edition and the newer edition, Edith Hamilton's mythology, which is kind of like the more popular one that is used in schools to learn about mythology. And over here is pretty much just kind of a conglomeration. I have Russia, some of these are textbooks, the Art of Japan, pre-modern Japan, yeah. Then coming down here, we still have a little bit of more Egypt, but then now we kind of go all the way past into pretty much Tudor England and Elizabethan England, because those are my favorite times in like the medieval period and the Reformation periods in England, when they kind of started going, oh, maybe we shouldn't live in the dark times, maybe we need to get like with it, kind of. And then some of my classic literature with from my favorite Disney movie of all time, Beauty and the Beast, Little Lumiere, this is the Funko Pop based off of the one with Emma Watson, the live action one. So we have my Shakespearean works here, then you have The Prince. Then we kind of get into Modest Proposal, Candid, and then into Victorian England, kind of. So we have At Home, which is kind of like comparing the home now in like Victorian England to back then. History of Scotland, The Other Victorians, which is a great book I have read because it shows another side of the upper crust aristocracies. Another kind of two-book duology on, I don't remember if it's the British or the American Victorians. So now down to my third shelf, which is all of my classic literature that blends into American history. So I have Longfellow, we have 101 Fairy Tales, The Brothers Grimm. These are the World Cloud Classic Editions that I bought from Barnes & Noble. Beautiful editions. I love the leather type feel, but also like the bendiness of the leather so it doesn't damage so easily. I have Hans Christian Andersen Tales. I have Pride and Prejudice, which is probably one of my favorite books. Then here I have my Pride and Prejudice and my Sense and Sensibility by Jane Austen manga classics that were made to kind of give another spin off of classics. Then I have Wuthering Heights, and this is actually the edition I read in high school. Heart of Darkness, Phantom of the Opera, which needs to be with my Roseblood, to be honest, but maybe I might put Roseblood in here. Feminine Mystique, because I'm obsessed with 10 Things I Hate About You, and I really want to read it, but I only bought it because of that movie. It's probably really bad saying that. I shouldn't buy books because of movies. Now we're kind of getting into American history and like the 13 colonies. So you have The Severity of Goodness of God that I had to read, Narrative of Life of Frederick Douglass, Autobiography of Benjamin Franklin, The Scarlet Letter, the House of Seven of the Seven Gables. And then over here, I didn't really know what to do with this because this fits into American history. So you've got Robert Frost, one of my favorite all-time favorite poets. Set Fair for Roanoke, Voyages and Colonies, 1584 to 1606. And Roanoke is the famous colony where that they came over here and settled, but then they disappeared. So I really wanted to know more about him. Another 1949 edition of Complete Poems of Robert Frost. Can't speak. Gilded Age and Progressivism. I think I'm saying that wrong. But another textbook that I had to read for another one textbook. And then you have Tim O'Brien and the Things They Carried, because they did not fit over here, even though they should be over here. And then Sarah Vowell, who is one of my favorite all-time historians, because she has such a sarcastic and dry sense of humor, and she just puts it out there so bluntly, and it's great. Because, yeah. So she's one of my favorite history writers. And then I have a lot of my 20th century classic literature over here. My favorite ones is George Orwell and Robert Graves. I had to read them for my English like history class since like 1600 something, I can't remember. Love the class. And then I also loved my literature and media class that was on the portrayal of, what's the word? The Holocaust, sorry, in World War II. So those are the books right here. And then over here is more history books. We have Having Our Say, we have Slaughterhouse-Five, George Orwell's 1984, In Cold Blood, Harry S. Truman, Summer of the Gods, David McCullough's Morning on Horseback, Hang-Ups from Way Back, which is another kind of textbook. Lee, my two favorite graphic novels that portrays sons trying to understand and tell the story of his father's time in Poland and Hungary, Austria-Hungary, during World War II, and his story, what was happening. And then Still Alive, which is Ruth Kluger's Cold War Exiles in Mexico. That is a great book. Had to read that for my senior seminar class. Love that book. Thank you so much to the professor who had to make me read that because I loved it. From Crossbow to H-Bombs, then we have China. As you can tell, I'm really in my favorite time periods at this point. And then two Sarah Vowell books. And then another graphic novel that is great on history, and if you need kids to read something for high school students to read in a very fun way, is the graphic Trinity Graphic History of the First Atomic Bomb. Love this to go over about the atomic bomb and like the summer outings. People would literally go on vacation just to go see these be detonated and didn't realize that they were literally poisoning themselves doing it. It's great. Love reading books, even if they're, some of them are fiction, some of them are not, of the Native American stories. And yeah, so that is bookshelf number two. So I really hope you guys enjoyed this bookshelf tour of my two books. Sorry at the end that I started kind of literally losing my thought process. It's been a long day, even though I didn't work very much today. So I hope you enjoyed. In looking at my history shelf, if you guys want to know more about my recommendations for history books, since I last 2 years was literally the history degree, which I'm pretty proud of being able to pull off in 2 years after switching my major sophomore year, just let me know. I would love to talk more about history books and read what you recommend for history books, because as I said, I love the Victorian period. I love classic literature. I love ancient Egypt and ancient Greece and Rome. I love modern kind of like history that pretty much brings out the negative points of the United States history. Just let me know. And if you have any recommendations, you kind of now have saw my taste in books. So yeah. Well, thank you so much for watching. I do apologize for not having a video up on Monday. This weekend was so, so chaotic that the vlog just didn't happen. And I may switch gears about if I should do a vlog every weekend now, especially when I start getting busy. I might be doing things on the weekend and won't have a reading vlog for you guys. So I'm kind of tootling around with that, but for now we'll do reading vlogs on Mondays and we may kind of veer away from it. And maybe I might do week-long vlogs, make 1 week a week-long vlog, and then do something else on Mondays. But anyways, thank you so much for watching. If you liked what you saw, please hit that subscribe button and that bell notification so you are notified when I post. I try to post every Monday and Thursdays. Sometimes it's Tuesdays and Fridays, but I try to stick to a schedule. But once I get busy, anyways, thank you again. Thank you so much. You have a wonderful rest of your week, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.